Okay, this is part five, the last part of our series on connecting our wood stove to the flue. This is the hard part, and this is the way I've chosen to do it. It might not be perfect, it might not look right, but I couldn't figure out any easier way to do this. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to hook up this elbow. All right, we're going to put it right in here. Okay, this is the elbow that we took off of the adapter. If you remember in an earlier video, we had those all connected together, so we took it off and put it on here. Now we're going to stick the stove pipe in the stove and mash it in. Okay, now we've got this kind of lined up a little bit. I'm going to have to move the stove in closer and then wrestle this thing around a little bit to get it on there. All right, so I'll just take the stove.
So close.
Okay, we're getting closer. Okay, I got this thing pretty close to being matched up. So I'm going to try to stick it in there. There we go. Okay, now we got it in there. We got to push it up further. We want this to be tilted back a little bit so that the angle of the air can go up to it, go up through the flue a little more easier. That quarter inch tilt makes a big difference. Straight. I think we're pretty good there. It's on there pretty tight. It ain't going nowhere. Okay. Now, this is designed to where you can take it apart and clean it. Alright. So what, if you wanted to take it apart, you just pull your stove out a little bit at a time. Disconnect this elbow. Pull it out. And you clean it with a chimney brush. Get down in here, take your damper out, clean this pipe with a chimney brush also. And you can do that 2 times a year or 3 times a year if you really want it. If you burn a lot of wood, the more you do it, the safer you'll be. the less chance you have of a chimney fire. So we're all connected up, and we're ready to start a fire. Okay, we're going to light a fire, and we're going to open up the damper a little bit. Vertical position.
All the way.
And it's parallel with the pipe, so that the air can go right up through there. And horizontal position closes it off so that a whole lot of smoke, a lot of air can get in there. We're going to leave it open and come down here. Okay, we're getting ready to light our fire. This is where Bo is going to assist me. Here, hold the light. Oh, he hasn't got that far. Okay, so, all right, you've got these two controls here for your fresh air and for your inside air circulation. And you want to push those both in. This is a Quadrifier 2100. It doesn't have a blower on it, but it works just fine. And what we're going to do is we're going to light this fire and see what she does. Now the fire, the sticks and everything are placed directly on the fire bricks. You don't need a hand iron to elevate it or anything like that. You just light it up and see what she does. Okay, we got this little gadget here. It's a little thermometer that basically tells you how hot your ideal optimal temperature is right up here in the Fahrenheit range. It's like 300 to 400 to 500. If it gets over that, this little needle, if it gets pegged into the red area, then that's kind of dangerous. You want to back it off. So we'll see eventually. We're going to burn it kind of slow and let this thing cure. It's going to cure over time. We hope you enjoyed our video today. If you enjoyed it, give us a like and subscribe to our channel if you'd like. We appreciate you watching, and we'll see you next time. Okay, that about wraps it up. We're just going to throw another log on the fire. There we go. Open those doors kind of slowly.